city had to go through an RFQ process, request for qualifications, through MDHA, and we were one of the submittals. When it came time to respond to the RFQ, we knew what we wanted to say because we were here, we were local, and we built a structure, designed a structure that was very compatible with Honky Tonk Row and the business district and the sports district. Out of 8 companies, we won it and we were off to the races.
Dean Oliver, who's now the chief vision officer of Brookfield Properties, that now owns the project and for whom we work, brought in a team and really spent several days just walking downtown and trying to get a sense of the built environment, the historical references, what makes Nashville, Nashville. You know, things like stone watermarks at the base foundations of buildings because we're so rich with stone here. Or Printer's Alley was an early inspiration where people were looking at just the scale, the materials, the brick, the warehouse aesthetic, that kind of thing. And so that really informed a lot of what Fifth and Broadway became. And in essence, the core of that is the L Street, which is the internal street that kind of connects everything together.
One of the most interesting parts about demolition here was it was a big thing to protect the public since we are on like the big, one of the busiest corners in Nashville. So we actually demoed from the inside out. So the exterior walls were the last thing to go. So we kind of chewed away from the inside. And so to the public, it looked like nothing was happening. And so I think the beginning of demo wasn't as exciting as taking down those exterior walls. And we were all standing in the excavation far enough away, and they started kind of pulling it back and pulling it down. So that was exciting when you could actually stand in the project and see Broadway after that.
You've got 3 distinct parts of the project here that have their own identity, have their own value proposition. And how do we coordinate that into one cohesive offer, and how do we brand around that? And it takes an amazing number of partnerships, starting with our contractors, our architects, city partnerships with our tenants, our vendors. I mean, I could go on and on. And so, taking those 3 parts of the property that have unique identities and pulling it all together has been the biggest challenge, but I think it's gonna be the most rewarding part as well too.
I think the biggest challenge for this project has been curating the right mix of tenants. We obviously want the tenants to be not just right for the project, but right for Nashville. We feel like we are stewards for Nashville in bringing in the right guys, whether it's the office tenants, whether it's the retail tenants. I think that's been one of the biggest challenges, is making sure that it's the right fit for the community.
My background is in architecture and urban planning, and in essence, this is what is a key component of what a city should have and should be. So basically, the idea is that you can live here, work here, shop here, dine here, get your basic services here, really without getting in a car. And then, and it doesn't just apply to Fifth and Broadway, it applies to the greater district. And what Nashville's becoming, which is really great to see, is truly a city, and an urban walkable city where people who choose to live downtown and work downtown really should depend on just walking or public transportation or bikes, what have you. Fifth and Broadway is an accomplishment in that we built this massive amount of square footage on 6.2 acres in the heart of downtown, and it's all opening within 6 months of each other. So this is not a phased long-term master plan where you build something and then you look at market conditions and you think about something 2 years later. This is all one package wrapped up in a bow, ready to be opened in March of next year.